Georgie and the Robbers by Robert Bright. This is Georgie, the gentle little ghost. He lives in the Whittaker house. Every night, as everybody knows, Georgie has to creak the stairs and squeak the parlor door to remind Mr. and Mrs. Whittaker that it's time to go to bed and to sleep. But Georgie never scared anybody. He was much too shy for that. So he had no idea of what he might have to do if strangers came into the house. Now, one night, Mr. and Mrs. Whittaker went to a church sociable in the village. And just as usual, they didn't even bother to lock the door. They never gave a thought to all the cozy antique furniture they had. Like the cozy old rocker on the porch, where Miss Oliver the owl sometimes liked to perch. Or like the comfortable old sofa in the parlor, where Herman the cat often snoozed. Or like all the old things that cluttered up the attic where Georgie lived. There wasn't an attic anywhere that was more clutter than Georgie's attic. It was full of old things no one could bear to part with. Now, old things like that are antiques and worth a lot of money. That is why there are people who sometimes try to steal them. That night, after the Whittakers had left the house, two strangers came down the country road. They drove a fast truck and wore masks. They were robbers. They took the rockers from the Whittakers' porch because they were old and antique. And they took the sofa from the parlor because it was even older than the rocking chairs and more antique. But from Georgie's attic, they took everything, every last thing, because everything up there was the oldest and most antique of all. Now that was a fine how-do-you-do. Herman ran after the truck, and Georgie ran after Herman. But the robbers went so fast, they would have gotten clean away if it hadn't been for Miss Oliver. She flew high under the moon and watched them. Suddenly, she heard a bang. The robber's truck had had a blowout. Miss Oliver flew after the robbers and saw where they hid the truck to fix the tire. It was in the barn where the harmless cow lived. The robbers drove the truck in and they put the cow out of her own barn. Miss Oliver flew straight back to tell Herman and Georgie. Herman decided he had better run to the village to warn Mr. and Mrs. Whittaker and the policeman. But Georgie and Miss Oliver went to be with the cow in the meadow. When they got to the barn, they all knew there was just one thing to do. They must scare the robbers away. The cow couldn't scare the robbers. She was much too harmless. Miss Oliver couldn't scare the robbers. She was just a soft, fuzzy owl. But Georgie was a ghost, and maybe he should have been able to scare somebody. But Georgie was such a gentle ghost. He was so little. Oh, if I could only be a big, scary ghost, just for once, Georgie thought. Just then, a wind came and began to billow the cover that kept the hay dry on the haystack in back of the barn. And Georgie looked at the cow, and he looked at Miss Oliver, and he looked at the haystack. And although he was a very small ghost, Georgie had a really big idea. Now the robbers were inside the barn fixing the tire, and they were already quite nervous. Suddenly, something came to the window and it said, "Moo." And that bothered the robbers, although they knew it must be a cow. Next, something flew under the eaves and it said, "Whoo." and that startled the robbers, although they knew it must be an owl. But then something else flitted past the door, and it said, "Boo!" And that made the robbers both jump and drop their tools, because they knew that a cow said moo, and they knew that an owl said hoo. But what was it that said boo? The robbers were so upset, they had to go outside and look. Now, what they saw at the corner of the barn was the flick of a white tail. But while it made their teeth chatter, they weren't scared enough to run. So they turned the corner of the barn and saw the flutter of white wings and one half of one big eye. But while it made their knees knock together, they weren't scared enough to run. So then they tiptoed to the next corner of the barn. And there they saw the biggest ghost in the world. That was enough to scare anybody. The robbers ran, and they ran. They ran straight into the arms of the village policeman. But Georgie was so surprised at himself for what he had done, he ran too. He ran and he ran. He ran straight home to tell the mice how he scared the robbers. That same night, the neighbors helped put the rocking chairs back on the porch and the sofa back in the parlor again. But best of all, they began putting everything, every last thing, back into the attic again, until it was properly cluttered with all the nice old things no one could bear to part with. And Georgie would stand on the old trunk and show the mice what had happened at the cow barn. He showed them over and over. And every night, he creaked the stairs and squeaked the parlor door again. But although Georgie knows, and the mice know, and Herman knows, and Miss Oliver knows, and the cow knows, and although you and I know, not even until this very day do the Whittakers know who scared the robbers.
Boo.